Welcome back. You're watching The Pulse. Let's talk equity strategy. Now, despite the ongoing debt crisis in Europe, the Stoxx 600 has outperformed the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange so far this year, but is now the time to invest in Israel. Terence Klingman is a senior analyst at Psagot Investment House. He joins us now from Tel Aviv. Interesting to see that you think that while the market is depressed, it's a hunting ground for investors looking for opportunities. Just walk us through where those opportunities are.
Yeah, I mean, you know, when you pull up the Tel Aviv Stock Exchange and you see the performance, we've been lagging the global markets. But when you break it down, I think it's even more startling. When you look at the top, you know, there are a number of tech stocks, exporters, which have really pulled up the market. Let's think about stocks like Teva, Mellanox, EasyChip. You know, they've really held up the market. When you start looking at the domestic stocks, they've really, really been pulled down. When you go to the benchmarks like not the TA25, the TA75, the performance is much worse. And we're starting to see basically a lot of delistings, a lot of buyouts, companies being yanked from the exchange, and we're getting 20-30% premiums. For example, just recently, Hot Telecommunications, active in the cable business, the mobile business. You know, we've had a lot of regulations here which have really, really hurt these companies. And then along comes the controlling shareholder and makes an offer to delist the minorities. We've seen it also in Granito Carmel. It's held up by the Azrieli Group, also industrial company, a bit of retail in it as well. Really, really suffered over the last year, again, due to a lot of domestic regulation that came as a result of the social protests that we've seen in Israel. And again, you have the controlling shareholder coming along and delisting it.
And how many other companies do you think are out there that could potentially see this happen, both either from controlling shareholders or private equity stepping in? How many more delistings do you think there'll be? And kind of what's your top five targets? Because those are the ones I want to buy into now.
Yeah, I mean, when you start to look at potential delistings, we've got Klal Industries and Investments. It was sold, the controlling share was sold from the IDB Group to a Russian investor, Len Blavatnik, Access Industries. You know, since he bought it, it's gone down a lot more even, so it's a good target for a buyout. And then there are a whole bunch of names, you know, going further down the list, which are also targets for buyouts. I mean, generally what tends to happen...
Sorry, Terence, are these guys paying up, just very briefly, because I've only got a couple of seconds left, are these guys paying a premium to the share price at the point at which they're buying these businesses at? Because I guess that's kind of critical.
Yeah, the premiums are very clear. They're in the 20-30% range, and you generally get a nice jump in the share when the delistings or the buyout offers are announced. So yeah, we're getting a nice little pops on the domestic, you know, beaten down domestic stocks that have been hurt by the regulatory environment, by the lack of investors, and we're getting 20-30% pops down.
Nice, very nice. Time that correctly, Terence, we've got to leave it there. We've got a break to take. Terence Klingman joining us from Psagot Investments out of Tel Aviv.